You know that this right here forever. Now allow me to reintroduce myself. They call me J-O, A to the easy E-N. Know that we undefeated, y'all are beneath them speeches, trying to air a grievance. But his lines are overhead, better check the air for clearance. Call the tower, this is our clear to heat the air apparent. Really, I've never been better. Legacy, this is forever. Right here forever. For a couple of months right now, we've been seeing a pretty big update to the Rotobrush tool inside Adobe After Effects. And the way they claim it to work is pretty revolutionary. So that's why I thought, let's take it to the test. And we're going to create these pretty cool scene transitions where Jill is going to jump in the air. We're going to rotoscope him out and then place him into a new scene. So we're driving to a pretty cool location right now to see how that Rotobrush tool works. The perks of being the boss. So basically how that Rotobrush tool works is you make a selection of your subject, and then automatically over time that selection or mask will follow your subject. And it's going to look at things like contrast in order to do that. Leaves or trees in the background is usually going to be super hard, super tricky for that Rotobrush tool, because we also see lots of contrast in there. So we're going to try the ultimate test now and just put Jill in front of a bunch of trees. Now for today, we brought the brand new MSI Creator 15 with us, which is a beast of an editing laptop. Thank you, MSI, for sponsoring today's episode. Now this thing right here comes very close to the editing workstations that we have in the office. It rocks the latest 10th generation Intel i7 CPU with 8 cores inside. It has the NVIDIA RTX 2080 graphical card inside and 32 gigs of RAM. And on top of that, we're looking right here at a beautiful 4K IPS display, which covers 100% of the Adobe RGB color space. Now, there is also a 17-inch version of this laptop with some upgrade possibilities. This laptop right here is made for visual effects and heavy video editing, so it is perfect for those who don't want to be fixed to a desktop, because this laptop replaces that. Now, it does put this laptop at a whole different pricing category. I mean, look at the specs, what's inside. And even though with all this hardware, they are still able to retain a pretty small form factor, which I'm pretty happy about. Now, it is making this laptop a little bit more heavy, but it's okay. But what I find the most amazing about this laptop is that it has an SD card reader inside. No longer you need to take dongles with you. I find that so important with laptops. So thank you, MSI. Now, to get that brand new Rotobrush 2.0 feature, what you have to do is open up your Creative Cloud desktop app, and from here on the left side panel, click on beta apps, from which you can install and download any of the beta programs. And of course, you want to install Adobe After Effects beta. So I've got Jill right here, a new composition, and it's at this point right here where it jumps in the air, where we'd like to Rotobrush him out. To do that, simply double click on that part, head over to the toolbox on top and click on the Rotobrush tool. Now with that tool, we can make a green selection of which part that has to be selected. And you can make multiple brush strokes if you like so, to make sure that we've selected Jill entirely. Now then, by holding down the Alt key on our keyboard, that Rotobrush will turn red, and we're going to make a selection of what the rotoscoping does not have to select. And then here on the left side where the Rotobrush effect has been applied to, we can see here version 2.0, which is the one that we need. Now it uses some kind of a sensei artificial intelligent thing in the background. I don't care. I just want to see how it performs. Now pretty nice as well about this tool is that if you click and hold under the Rotobrush tool, we get this refine edge tool, which is great for hair and stuff. And this allows you to make a selection around the hair of your subject to get better results of that. All right, let's go back to the composition and see how that looks. And it looks pretty good. You can always go into the Rotobrush effect and from there refine things like the feather, the contrast, the edge and everything. But yeah, this is pretty good. I'm pretty surprised actually.
All right. Hang on, what is this for spooky witchcraft? Well, here you can see the traditional Rotobrush next to version number 2. and it is not slow anymore like before. Seriously, I would actually never use the Rotobrush because it was super slow and it never worked. But version 2 works so well that it's almost like you don't need a green screen anymore. So what I did further was shooting Jill at different locations. Every time I would put him in the same spot of the camera frame. And every time he jumps in the air, we rotoscope him out like we've seen before and cut to the next location where he starts with that same jump. I first placed an empty shot of the second location underneath him. This allows me to create any kind of transition from one location to the other while Jill floats on top. But when he drops, we of course cut to the normal shot of location number 2. Now there's gonna have to be a cut somewhere, but to make that as seamless as possible, I used the puppet pin tool. Create a bunch of points on the rotoscope Jill. Then go forward in time and move these points to match the two Jills better together. And if you see some weird lines, then make sure to increase the mesh from the puppet pin effects. And that's basically it. And because the rotoscoping was just going so smooth, I thought to key out Jill for the entire scene. And this allowed me to add more elements to the background. And these are all coming from Storyblocks, so it was just a matter of dragging and dropping them inside After Effects. And because we have Jill rotoscoped out on a different layer, we can just put them in between the background and Jill. And we've got ourselves an amazing dance video made in just a couple of hours. You know that this right here, boy. Now allow me to reintroduce myself. They call me J-O-N to the easy E-N. Know that we undefeated, y'all are beneath them speeches, trying to air a grievance. But his lines are overhead, better check the air for clearance. Call the tower, this is our grid, and he the heir apparent. Really, I've never been better. Legacy, this is forever. Right here for Rev. And that was it for this video. Now I'm going to enjoy this laptop a little bit more before I'm gonna have to send it back. Yeah, it was a loner. Damn it. I think I'm gonna buy it. Or I'm just not gonna send it back. Thanks for watching. Thank you, MSI, for the laptop. If you wanna get it back, come and get it. But don't forget, stay creative. So guys, since it was going so easy to rotoscope Jill, I thought, let's put like this green solid in the background. I'm gonna render that out and give you guys a download link to that in the description down below. Do something fun with it, I'd say, and if you publish it to Instagram or so, make sure to tag us so we can have a good laugh as well.